How well can we stay with these receivers if we're in man coverage? Because he just did it on that one. Force the incompletion. That allowed him to get bolder with his pass rush, won't it?
Absolutely. Freeze up your guys elsewhere. Third and long for Vic. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It'll be a gain of 17, but even with that, they'll be well short here for fourth down. On fourth down, here's Andy Leon to kick it away. Back deep is Tyreek Hill. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Time with Ricky Williams. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
They stick to the ground game on first down. It's Williams. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case...
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. John Randall coming up the middle, gets him there for a loss of about 9. A play fake. Now McNabb rolling to his right. And got his man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Give him 30 yards there.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket, because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside. And he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
Now a handoff. Here's Williams. Room here to run. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. 31 yards there and a first down. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
And he'll get about 3 just outside the 10, stopped at the 11.
Now that call makes sense, because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Second down, McNabb. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And it's a touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Mandalites have taken the early lead. And now a 2-point conversion attempt forthcoming. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble, as he'll bring this one out to the 27.
Now this offense about ready to take over again. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trade expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Throwing, Vic, buying time to his left. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be 2nd down.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Here's Michael Vick to the right side of Eric Ebron. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter. A 2nd down completion got him 7. Now here's 3rd and 3.
Line. 300. Eagle.
From the gun, Vic trying to get it to Ebron, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
Ohio! Cut! Flex route!
They'll hand it off now, Williams. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Ohio!
On 2nd down, Williams down right around the 25. Only a yard on the pickup, and now they've got a 3rd down and 8.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
On 3rd down, that's Williams. Williams loses the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. And Bryant's kick is good. And that will extend the lead to 11-0. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for 3. And it does feel like settling when that happens, doesn't it?
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of credit where it's due, and that's to the defense because they ran onto the field. This is what we call sudden change, right? Interception, you've got to go put out the fire, and they did, holding them to a field goal.
They begin the drive with Williams. And a nice spin into some open field. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. Two minutes to go here in the first half. Back with more after this. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another 1st and 10. Vick will look to throw on 1st down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
Now a toss left side. It's Williams. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. He lost two there, and it's third down.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
On third down, Vic fighting through pressure, but he can't get away forever, and down he goes. And a timeout here. Timeout taken, whistles blown. Timeout taken by the receiving team as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it.
And it's a black team now. By 90, by 20. What is it?
They will indeed go for it. Vic. Now he'll let it go deep over the middle. And they will not be able to hook up there. It's incomplete. A surprising move to go for it. And predictably, at least somewhat predictably, it doesn't pay off. And the ball will go over on downs on the short side of the field. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Now a first down throw. McNabb being chased out left. And he gets it down to the 32. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
They'll run it with Williams. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a third and 8. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here, as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Well, good field position to start the drive, but under the gun now here on third and 8.
Cut.
Now Williams. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number 2. Now Bell. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here, because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right up. And this will be a touchdown. Le'Veon Bell, as the first half is winding down. And the Madden Elites, they extend their lead.
I heard a coach talk about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
They start the drive on the ground. It's Williams. A very good move, but for a relatively modest gain out near the 32. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a second and 3. Vic on second down. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. So 2 quarters. You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it.